Let us come to now, sir, some more steps of self-discovery. Number one is face your challenges or negativity. The moment you start understanding self, the rewards unfold. Let me tell you, I did 2-3 exercises of this nature. You just start knowing that you are an authentic person, and then you nurture yourself and love yourself. Of course, I am a human being, so I do have negative thoughts, and the negative thoughts distress or create disharmony. And definitely, they are the obstacles to my inner growth. I am talking about inner growth. I may be having handsome package, I have a good job, I have a good status, but my inner growth has also to develop. What you can do is just try to understand your behavior and change. Try to understand your thinking process. Why I was limited to that simple aspect? Why not I am going beyond? Even you try to improve your emotions when you understand self. And most important, you forgive many people. Try to forgive yourself. Then there will be no obstructions and you will move further. Most of the situations, you are familiar with what I have. We celebrate Diwali, we celebrate festivals, we celebrate birthdays, we celebrate happy occasions. So the concept is, friends, here, celebrate yourself. How? Not just greeting to self, looking at the mirror, happy birthday Deepak. Celebrate yourself, here I mean to say is, you try to acknowledge the abilities, skills or strengths you have. Okay? Then the more you try to know what are your strengths, abilities and skills and what you are good at, you will be happy. And the perceived weaknesses will definitely reduce. So there can be different occasions. Just listen to a music of your choice and just love yourself, finding this is one way I can celebrate my strength, my capabilities, my skills, my joy of happiness, and the celebration concept can be applied to yourself also. One quote I remember, which is here on my slide: you really have to look inside yourself and find your own inner strength and say, I am proud of what I am, who I am, and I am just going to be myself. Wonderful quote. What you can do practically on this point, just try to list down the activities you enjoy. If I listen to a classical music, vocal or instrumental, if I am happy and I enjoy reading self-help books or comics or fictions, just list down such activities. And also look at what things excite you, what inspires you, what makes your heart sing. There is nothing more than that, celebration of self. Yes, you will like or may not, but the question I am raising now as a third step is, ask the purpose of your life. See, you were not responsible for the birth you have taken, but then your existence on this earth has a purpose. Just ask by looking at the mirror, what I want out of life which I have. my soul has certain purpose of existence that has to bring certain fulfillment in my life? Just try to ask. Find out your dreams and goals. Jot down. Grab the opportunity to fulfill your goals and dreams, maybe physically, maybe mentally, or maybe spiritually. Do you have in your life what you call it as core values? List them out. Maybe honesty, love, kindness, integrity. Just to share one example, that I am at the signal on a road, on a square, and the signal is red, I am stopping there. Knowing very well that the other three roads, no passenger, no transport, nothing is present. But because the signal is red, irrespective of the time shown in my wristwatch, if I follow it, it's an integrity. If I find something which is not mine, I try to just look at who has lost this pouch here and I just try to hand over. Honesty. These are the personal values. Just find out, are these personal values are listed down by you for yourself? If yes, clarify them. Clarify them not only for one role as a manager or a professor, whatever situation is, but try to clarify those values. I am a father, or somebody is mother, I am son, or a daughter, or a wife, or a husband, or a co-worker, or a colleague. In all roles, you should clarify these values. Your core values of your personality help you add up to your decision-making process. Yes. Just try and you will also enjoy what I have done it. The important thing is that do you get inspiration from positive things? Example, you follow a role model, maybe your teacher or a father or a elder brother or a sister, anybody. Do you read self-improvement books? If not, please go ahead. That will help you in inspiring self. Look for teachers or mentors who will help you. Sometimes, just go with the nature, you will get a positive energy, beautiful scenery, wonderful climate, and with the nature, that positive energy comes in you and you get inspired, you get fresh, you get different dimension of the self. Sometimes, if you can get mental relaxation, the understanding of self will be still better. Time for self-reflection or meditation is equally important. You should give, you should spare time. I hope you must be doing the same thing I did many a times. You know a person, but to understand a person very well, you have spent some time with that person. Similarly, to understand self, you will have to give time. To build a relationship with self, you need to spend time to know yourself. To love self is the beginning of lifelong romance. Yes, I repeat. To love self is the beginning of lifelong romance because the entire life you are going to lead for you. So just love yourself and the lifelong romance would be fantastic. If possible, go for a meditation program. It may give you something called self-reflection. It may give you some peace and so on. Friends, I have a habit of writing a diary. What I do, I write in my diary the activities that I have conducted in a day, the experience that I shared with somebody, the learning that I had on this day, and or in the current 21st century, if you so to speak, instead of writing a diary, write a blog. What happens if you write a diary, if you write a blog? You normally like to write likes and dislikes that you have. You like to react to the situations, but you would like to write those reactions to the experiences. So, if you write such things, you can provide certain clues about your own emotions, how looking at the diary or a blog, you try to understand your emotions, your strengths and weaknesses, and the areas that you never knew about yourself. And when you just go through this type of diary or a blog, you try to give an opportunity for you to grow and heal. Because this is how a flow of writing expression comes to you. You are free enough to share it as it is a personal diary. And this is how an outlet to your emotions, feelings and thinking gets coordinated. And this is also an equal and important step to the self-discovery. Friends, for last few minutes, I have been talking on self-discovery, what it is, how would you like to go for self-awareness. The key to living a magical life is to be authentic, be who you are, have the courage to say no, stand in your own divinity. This is how the magical life will come forward. Yes, self-discovery is not a one-day affair or a one-hour affair or a one-week affair. Many a times, spiritually, mentally, emotionally, psychologically, it may take lifetime to understand self. But let's not just keep quiet, close your hands and just sit down idle. That's not fair. You will have to understand self. The more you know yourself, the more empowered you will be or you are to be. If you are clear about what is my existence and purpose of life, a clear self will result in my enhanced or renewed confidence. I may have some more strengths, and that is my first point. I live purposefully, now I understand, and I am really, truly happy. So friends, celebrate yourself, enjoy the discovery of self, and more and more about self. That's all what I would like to share with you today. Thank you.